Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. How's everyone doing? Obviously, the Lakers season came to an end last night against the Phoenix Suns. Not what we wanted to see. Not a great moment, but there is some talk about potentially running it back, bringing back this same squad for the Lakers. Joining me to talk about it a little bit is Ron Gutterman from LakersNation.com. Ron, you were in the building. Any insight you can give us from Staples Center last night before we dive into this topic?
I mean, look, it was clear in the building from warmups that the energy was just not there with the team. Anthony Davis wasn't right. KCP wasn't right. He hit a few good warmup jumpers, but like, it was really spotty beyond that. It didn't seem like the energy was there. And you could tell from the first 5 minutes, the Lakers just didn't have it. This just wasn't their year.
Yeah, and certainly injuries were a big factor in that. And that is a big part of why you're now hearing a number of guys on the team say, let's run it back, because they don't feel like we got to see, or they even got to see, the true Lakers. LeBron said it himself. We never really got to see this team at full strength. And that has led to a number of guys saying, hey, we want to try this again next year and hopefully not deal with as many injuries as they did. Now, Anthony Davis kind of played both sides of this issue here. Here's what he had to say. He said, hopefully, in regards to bringing guys back, hopefully, but that's each guy's decision. We wanted the same thing last year, and it doesn't work that way. Guys look out for themselves and their families and do what they think is best for them, and you can do nothing but respect it. The most important thing is I want everybody to get healthy. A lot of guys played through injuries this year, and I played through it. We want everyone to be healthy, and if guys feel like this season was a fluke, I say for us because of the injuries, and we didn't get a chance to really reach our potential because of the injuries, then let's do it. But at the end of the day, I know guys still have a lot to think about. So, what do you think about that, Ron? I mean, the concept that the Lakers coming out of this playoff series are dissatisfied and they feel like they never got the opportunity to really show what they can be. And that now has them in a mindset of, let's bring it back and let's go again next season so we can right this wrong.
Yeah, I mean, look, the Lakers are in a pretty good position. There are certain teams, and we can talk about all of those teams, but there are certain teams who, if they get eliminated or have already been eliminated in the first round, running it back is not an option because it's been proven time and time again it doesn't work. I'm thinking about Portland. I'm thinking about potentially the Clippers tonight if things go awry for them. Yeah. The Lakers are in a unique position. They lost in the first round, but they could realistically run it back and still be considered championship contenders. Maybe not championship favorites, but contenders. So that's a really good position to be in. Anthony Davis, obviously, he didn't want to be too, you know, committed either way just because they wanted to run it back last season, like he said. But it's going to be a unique offseason for them.
I think it's interesting, Ron, because from a lot of Lakers fans, the knee-jerk reaction last night on the postgame show was blow this thing up, right? Get rid of everybody, trade them all, bring in new players. Can we trade for this star? Can we trade for this guy? What can we do, right? They wanted to see change. But then from the players themselves, they're saying, we didn't get to really show who we actually are. Let's keep this thing together. Let's do this again. Now, I do think AD is right, though. Look, they wanted to keep things together last season, but that's not typically how it works. You don't keep an entire team together. Now, you could say the Lakers had too much turnover from last season to this season. I think that's definitely a topic you can argue, but it's unlikely they actually do bring everybody back. But I think it is going to be interesting to see if there's some key pieces that do come back here. But AD also mentions the fact that it's still fresh and it's still raw. That has players responding emotionally, just as fans were responding emotionally last night when they were saying, hey, let's get rid of a lot of players. Players were responding emotionally, saying, no, we don't want to give up here. Let's keep going. Let's keep this thing together and run it back. But a few months from now, when free agency actually starts, things might be a little bit different once they have a little bit of separation, a little bit of space from this moment.
Yeah, and I think last season, because the gap between the championship and free agency was so small, the front office did a really good job navigating the emotion of the players and saying, hey, look, I know you want to run it back, but we can't. We simply cannot run this team back. I think this year it's going to be the opposite effect, where there's going to be a lot of time until the free agency and the offseason begins. And that willingness to run it back is going to kind of fade, and it's going to be up to the front office to reignite it if they do want to run it back.
I think ultimately, too, it's going to come down to dollars, right? The Lakers do not have a lot of flexibility. They are going to be a capped-out team, and they've got a number of guys who are now going to be free agents. I mean, we're talking about Dennis Schroeder, Talen Horton-Tucker will be restricted, Alex Caruso, Andre Drummond, Markieff Morris, Wesley Matthews, Marc Gasol. We don't know. Is he playing another season? He's got another year under contract, but is he playing? We don't know. There's a lot of question marks there from a number of different players that are on this roster right now. And fewer I didn't even mention. So when it comes down to it, it could be a matter of just finances. Logistically, can you bring back all of these guys? Probably not, but it'll be interesting to see which ones the Lakers do target to keep and which ones they decide to move on from.
Yeah, I mean, look, they have 10 free agents of their 15-man roster. They have 10 free agents. Talen Horton-Tucker is the only one of those 10 that's restricted. 9 unrestricted free agents is like unprecedented, and it could be 10 unrestricted if Marc Gasol decides to retire. That's 10 roster spots you have to work on filling. So a lot of these guys are going to be back simply because the Lakers don't have a lot of cap flexibility, right, in terms of keeping these guys, getting new guys. But yeah, of course there's going to be roster turnover. There are 10 open roster spots, unprecedented for a team 1 year removed from a championship.
But let me ask you this, Ron, to sum things up. So there were some Lakers fans last offseason who were happy that the Lakers made the changes that they made and brought in the players that they brought in and didn't just run it back. There were others who felt the opposite, who felt like they should have just run it back. You keep Rondo, whatever the cost, right? He made, what, just over $7 million. You keep everybody. You keep Dwight. You keep JaVale. You keep all of those guys. Bring everybody back and let them try to run it back and win a back-to-back championship. How are you feeling right now with this squad? If the Lakers were to bring everyone back, would that be a mistake because they aren't coming off of a championship? Or how do we view that?
A lot of Lakers fans are probably going to disagree with me. I feel better about running it back with this group than I did about running it back with last year's group. I think if the Lakers run it back with last year's championship team, I'm not even sure they make the playoffs this year. Because with LeBron,
with the injuries, right?
With the injury, LeBron, okay, and AD getting hurt, that Lakers team last year was too old. They were too slow. They were not self-sufficient enough as players to hold their own. Rajon Rondo in the regular season was not going to put the team on his back when LeBron and AD got hurt. Dennis Schroeder tried. He tried his hardest. It didn't work great, but he tried. So I feel like running it back with this year's team is actually more likely to have success just because it's a younger team, it's a little bit more of an energetic team, and it's a little bit more of a team that's on Anthony Davis's timeline compared to LeBron James's. And I just feel better about this unit than I did about last year's running it back.
And I can see the argument for that, certainly. I will say that I don't think they're going to. I think that there's going to be some fairly major changes. I think we're going to see some trades as well. I think the Lakers are going to be pretty aggressive in terms of going out there and doing what they need to do in order to kind of, you know, add a few pieces to this roster, particularly where their shortcomings this year were so obvious. Outside of injuries, it was the shooting that was such a big problem. So I would expect to see that addressed in this offseason. But again, Anthony Davis mentioning that sentiment is certainly there, and he's okay with the concept of running it back and bringing back these players. So something to keep an eye on as we move towards the offseason, as we move towards free agency. How many of these guys wind up coming back for next year's squad? And then is that a good thing or not? Let me know what you guys think, though. Fire it off in the comments down below. Make sure you do also subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. And don't forget to turn on notifications. But give us your thoughts. Who should come back? And who do you think should find a new place to play basketball next season? Till next time, everybody. See ya and stay safe.